Hi everyone, it's Janis here with a new episode to help you build better daily structure and be in control of your life. Productivity doesn't just randomly happen. Often, productivity is a result of structured approach and continuous effort. So today, we'll take a look at how you can create your weekly structure for productivity. We will cover some of the best techniques and greatest practices that productive people use to create weekly structure that keeps them on track. If this is your first time on this channel, then make sure you subscribe and hit the bell icon to get updates on my latest videos about time management and productivity. Weekly planning approach is great because it's long enough to be ahead of the game and short enough to have sense of urgency to take action. Week itself has a structure. Every week starts with Monday, followed by Tuesday, and so on. And every week ends with Sunday. People, however, build their structure on top of the week. If you think about it, then every Wednesday is usually more or less the same every week, same as every Friday and Saturday. For example, you might have a dance lessons every Monday and Thursday, or you might go for a lengthy run every Saturday morning. I personally cook my meals every Monday, Wednesday and Friday between 6:30 p.m. and 8 p.m. and I do my shopping always on Saturdays. If you build the right weekly structure for yourself, then you'll be able to save some time and get more things done. So let's dive in and find out how to create weekly structure for productivity. Number one, pick your planning tool. Your planning tool is your environment where you'll have your plan. This can be a digital environment if you're using a mobile or web application. Or you can choose to create your weekly plan in the journal. There is no right or wrong here. You have to choose whatever works for you the best. I personally use Google Calendar as my planning tool. I like it because I can use it on my computer and phone. It is also great that it allows me to create recurring events, and it is flexible to adjust as I can just drag and drop my events if my schedule is changing. Number two, time block. There are multiple ways how you can plan your time, but by far my favorite way of planning time is time blocking. Time blocking is an approach where you allocate time blocks for specific activities in your schedule, and that in turn keeps your schedule structured. So rather than having a list of few things that you hope to get done with time blocking, your Wednesday evening could look like this. 5 p.m. till 6 p.m. gym. 6 p.m. till 7:30 writing a blog post number 45. 7:30 till 8 p.m. team meeting. 8 p.m. till 9 p.m. dinner. And 9 p.m. till 9:30 evening routine. Describing time blocking in detail is outside of the scope of this video, but I have another video that explains everything that you need to know to become a time blocking pro. It is called Time Blocking Mastery, the ultimate guide. I will link it in the cards and in the description below. Number three, have your planning slot. Next step is to allocate a time slot for when you're going to do your weekly planning. Now, this might seem like a little detail, but I can tell you that it has a huge impact. I would suggest creating it as a routine and do your weekly planning at the same day and at the same time every week. I do my weekly planning on Saturday mornings with a fresh head before I have done anything else to make sure that I give it my full focus. Number four, theme your weekdays. To give your weekly plan more structure, it is important to theme your days. This means having one important thing that you need to focus on that day. Just to give you an example, this is how I currently theme my days. On Mondays, I focus on working on my business structure, reporting, and infrastructure development. Tuesdays and Thursdays are my content production days. This is when I write my scripts, voice them, and write my video descriptions. Wednesdays are for engaging with my community and research. Fridays are for product development. On Saturdays, I focus on strategy and admin work. And on Sundays, I have buffer time and of course, some rest. It is important to know that over time, your themes will change depending on your goals. But having a theme helps you to get in the right mode and get things done. Number five, plan for your goals. Okay, we've just discussed some preparation steps that are important. You then sit down with your planning tool and are ready to start planning your week. How do you start? During the previous week, you have probably accumulated a lot of thoughts and ideas, so you might be tempted to put it all down on your next week's schedule, but not so fast. That is the easiest way to keep yourself busy and not productive. The right way to plan your week is to plan activities that will help you to achieve your goals. So pull out your goals and make sure that activities that you're planning to do next week are in line with the goals that you're trying to achieve. If you haven't written your goals down or even set them, then be sure to check out my video on goal setting. I'll link it in the cards and a description below. Number 6, plan buffer times. When you plan your week, you might want to fill up your schedule as much as possible because you don't want to waste any time. But that is one of the biggest mistakes that people make, and instead of being productive, people become overwhelmed by their schedule. The solution is simple. You have to make sure that you include buffer times into your schedule in case things take longer to complete or you have some additional work that needs to be done. Number 7, flexibility is the key. If you want to be successful with your weekly plan, then you have to accept the idea that things will change, and therefore you have to be flexible with your schedule. If I make my plan on Saturday morning and then on Saturday evening something unexpected happened that I need to take care of, then I need to update and adjust my plan. Remember that just because you have to change your plan doesn't mean that the plan is bad. It just means that there are now different circumstances. On the end note, I wanted to ask you the question, what is the biggest obstacle in your life that is stopping you to plan effectively? Is it distractions around you, or maybe you don't have a clear goal in your life? Let me know in the comments below. I hope that this video gave you a good understanding about how you can create your weekly structure to become more productive. If you enjoyed this video and you're interested in productivity and time management, then check out my free Mastermind coaching program where I teach my complete productivity framework, starting from setting out a vision and then breaking it down into goals, projects, and actionables. It's a live coaching environment where I do consistent live coaching videos as well as Q&A sessions so you can ask me questions and get instant answers. Join now and take your productivity to the next level. I'm looking forward to seeing you inside.